Hi, in this video we'll see how to implement Kerala Flood Cess in Tally ERP9. Before that, we'll know why Kerala Flood Cess is imposed. Kerala Flood Cess is levied to raise the funds required for reconstruction of state after the devastating flood occurred in the state during August 2018. From when Kerala Flood Cess is applicable? Kerala Flood Cess is applicable from 1st August 2019 onwards. What is the rate of Kerala Flood Cess? Kerala Flood Cess is applicable at 1% for the goods chargeable to GST at 12%, 18% and 28%. And 0.25% for the goods chargeable to GST at 3% and 1% for all taxable services and nil for goods chargeable to GST at 5%, nil rated and exempted. Now we'll see how to implement the same in Tally ERP9. Kerala Flood Cess is applicable from Tally from release 6.5.3. This feature can be enabled only after 6.5.3. So, if you are using a release lower than 6.5.3, then please download it from Tally website. It is www.tallysolutions.com. And it is good to note that this video is not for a fresher, not for a beginner. This video is for the users who is already using Tally and who is already enabled GST feature. Now we'll see how to enable Kerala Flood Cess in Tally ERP9. To enable that, first we need to install release 6.5.3. After installing, come to F11 features. Under F11 features, statutory and taxation. Under statutory and taxation, enable the second parameter from top, set or alter GST details. Enable this feature. After that, you come to Kerala Flood Cess applicable. You need to be enabled this particular parameter and applicable from need to give 1st August 2019 and accept the screen and accept again, come out completely accepting. Now the feature has been enabled in this module. Now need to update the rates in stock items. To update rate in stock items, you can come to inventory info from Gateway of Tally. Under inventory info, tax rate setup, select tax rate setup, come to GST. Here you can see the list of stock items which is already created and billing. Now we have a stock item applicable chargeable to 12%, 18%, 28%, 3% and 5%. Now we'll see how to set Kerala Flood Cess to these stock items. Here select the stock item by pressing space bar. After selecting, click on set rates from right side vertical button bar, or you can press even Alt S. Once you press, you will get GST details screen. Here you can come down to last bottom parameter, Kerala Flood Cess. Here give 1% for the stock item chargeable at 12%, and here give the applicable rate as 1st August 2019 and accept it. Now you can see here the rate has been updated here. Same thing can be done for item chargeable at 18%. Press space bar, click on set rate, come down, give 1%, give the period as 1st August and accept it. Now again do the same for 28%. Press space bar, click on set rate, come down 1%, give the applicable date, accept it. Now do the same for 3%, space bar, set rate, and for 3% you can give us 0.25%. Applicable is 1st August, accepting. And for 5%, it is nil. So I am not giving any Kerala flood cess for 5%. I have given for 12%, 1%, 18%, 1%, 28%, 1%, and for 3%, I have given 0.25%. Now we will see how to record a sales transaction. I am coming out from Gateway of Tally. I am going to Accounts Info. Accounting Vouchers. Under Accounting Vouchers, I am coming to Sales. Here, date has to be applicable from 1st August. So, I am pressing F2. It is applicable from 1st August. So, I am giving 1st August and accepting. Now, my date got changed 1st August 2019. Now, I will start billing. I am selecting the party as local registered buyer. I am selling to a local registered buyer. So, I am accepting. Here you can see that Kerala flood cess is applicable for only transactions within the state, that is transactions made within Kerala. It is called intrastate transactions. So, Kerala flood cess is applicable only for intrastate transactions and not for interstate transactions. So, I am selected here Kerala. If GST is there, you can give the GST. Now, I don't have a sales ledger. So, I am creating sales ledger. Supply of goods under sales, GST applicable, and type of supplies, goods, accepted. Now I am selecting name of item. Here you can see I am selecting stock item chargeable at 18% and giving quantity, rate, amount, and accepting. Now I am selecting the tax components, CGST, SGST. Now I am selecting, I don't have Kerala flood cess, so I am creating Kerala flood cess head. I am pressing Alt C to create a ledger from voucher. So I have created account Kerala flood cess. It should be categorized under, it should be grouped under duties and taxes, and select type of duty or tax as GST. And tax type as Kerala flood cess and accept it. Now can you see is Kerala flood cess is calculating? It is not calculating because Kerala flood cess is applicable only on sales made to unregistered dealers and sales made to final consumers. To a local consumer, to a local unregistered dealer. Now, I will change the party. I am coming back and I am changing to local unregistered dealer. The party I changed it to local unregistered dealer. Now, you can see here it has calculated. Kerala flood cess is calculated 100 rupees. Now, again I am going back and I am changing to local registered dealer. See, once I select local registered dealer, cess is not calculating. So, how can I check what is the type. For that, come back, select the party name, and under that press Control Enter. Once you press Control Enter, you will get ledger alteration screen. The ledger alteration screen will get opened. Here you can see registration type. This registration type, if it is regular, then it will not calculate. It should be either consumer or unregistered. Only then it will get calculated. So now I'm going back and I'm selecting consumer. Once I select consumer, again it started calculating. And also this Kerala flood cess is applicable only for Kerala state. See, what I'll do, I'll change the party of interstate registered dealer. I'm selected, so nothing is getting calculated. Again I'm coming back, interstate consumer, no, it is not calculating. Again coming, interstate unregistered dealer, no, it is not calculating. So again I'm coming to local consumer, yes, it is calculating. So again I'm coming to local unregistered, yes, it is calculating. So it has understood that Kerala flood cess is applicable only for unregistered and consumers, not for a registered dealer. Now you can see the same calculations from tax analysis by clicking on tax analysis, or you can press Alt A. Now you can check the tax calculation part by pressing Alt F1. You can see the breakup, same how it is calculated. Kerala flood cess, 1%, 100 rupees is calculating on 10,000. So this cess is not calculating on tax. This Kerala flood cess is calculating on taxable value, not on tax. Usually cess will calculate on tax, but Kerala flood cess will calculate on taxable value and not on tax. This has to be noted. Now I'm accepting this particular invoice. After accepting, you can see how it will be printed. So I'm going to print. So I'm going to the print preview. Now you can see here a separate column, KFC rate 1% it is showing. If you are not getting this particular column, you can come out and again you go to print, press F12 from print screen for configuration, then under statutory details enable print Kerala flood cess percentage column. Only then you will get a percentage column in invoice. I hope this video was helpful to you. For more videos, please comment your requirement. Based on that, we'll release an upcoming video. Thank you for watching.